Hi, I'm Daniela. I'm a movement specialist and Feldenkrais practitioner. And here are some examples that I want to give you that you might want to try out. There are typical Feldenkrais movements. And make sure you follow us also on Facebook with updates about our services. Here is a movement that can help you getting up and down from a chair without creating more back or neck pain. So, the first important thing here is that you're really bending from the hip joint, and a lot of people don't know where the hip joint is. So when you find your pockets here, where you fold in the pants, that's where you want to bend from. You don't want to bend from the waist, because if you bend from the waist, you're bending your spine and you're hurting yourself. But if you bend from the hips and you sit into the hip joints, like I call it the wrestling position or skiing position, like where you're really leaning down into your hips here. That's a very stable, strong position that you can bend from. So you're not slouching and bending your spine or hyperarching. You just want to find these joints, and then you bend your hips there first and then the knees. Like a lot of people have the idea you want to bend your knees when you lift, right? That hurts your knees. But you should really bend from the hips. When you bend at the hip, you use your big muscles of your glutes and your core, and you're stable and safe. And that's the same thing you use when you're coming from sitting to standing. So you bend at the hips, and then you can comfortably sit down. Same thing when you come up. You really want to make sure you sit in front of the chair. Your feet are positioned in a way that you're stable, and then you're using again these hip joints, and you can even prepare and feel them right there. And when you're ready and you do that, you feel the compression from your feet in the ground, you push through your heels and it plops you right up. And the same way when you go down, you bend and you come back down. What's important is don't let the knees go in. Don't stand too far out. The feet should be aligned under the knees aligned under the hip. And now you do that hinging, you come up using your glutes and your core to come up, and you will be safe, and it's much easier, and you will be actually stronger.